21 totals, despite a couple of little hiccups we had there. Matty Thomas into the equal lead for the first time with his two votes in that win over Glenelg. No votes for Sammy Gray. Zane Kirkwood getting them to move into equal fourth. So he's going very well. James Boyd votes in all three games, including the loss to Norwood, where he had 14 clearances and picked up a vote there. We have two rounds to go, so we are going to go round by round. North Adelaide in round 22 have the bye, so Maxi Thring can't win. Thomas, Gray, Boyd and Kirkwood are all still in the race for the medal. Let's take a look at round 22.
Round 22. A barnstorming 9-goal final term earned Central a big win against Glenelg at Elizabeth. New dad Brad Symes, the star for the Dogs, with 33 disposals. West sport the Alberton farewell of Port skipper James Micklejohn, but it was the Magpies' Steve Summerton and Sam Gray getting another dose of leather poisoning.
He did. It was pretty nice mark in the end.
Interim South coach Kim Cobb claimed a win with his only match at the helm. Panther Nick Liddell starring with 26 touches and a goal.
Here's a chance for Hurigan. It's dribbling. It's bouncing. It's a goal.
And Norwood continued its march towards September with a 41-goal win against the Eagles at Woodville. Matt Thomas collecting 30 disposals for the visitors.
Runs around him, steadies himself and kicks a brilliant goal.
Round 22. Central District versus Glenelg. Central District, B. Symes, one vote. Central District, L. Harbel, two votes. Central District, J. Boyd, three votes. Sturt versus South Adelaide. South Adelaide, M. Wunke, one vote. South Adelaide, N. Liddell, two votes. Sturt, M. Yench, three votes. Port Adelaide versus West Adelaide. Port Adelaide, S. Gray, one vote. Port Adelaide, S. Summerton, two votes. Port Adelaide, H. Slattery, three votes. Eagles versus Norwood. Norwood, P. Bampton, one vote. Norwood, O. Fantasia, two votes. Norwood, M. Thomas, three votes. And that completes the voting for round 22.
One round to go. Let's take a quick look at the leaderboard there. James Boyd kept up his end of the bargain, getting three, but it didn't matter. Matty Thomas into the outright lead for the first time tonight. Henry Slatter and Steve Summerton getting the votes, obviously, over Sammy Gray with just the one there. Our final round of the night, I'd like to ask John Olsen to join me up on the stage now to get ready to announce the winner for round 23. It is a race in two, obviously, with Matty Thomas and Sam Gray still a chance to win the McGarry medal. Norwood knock off North by 51 points and Port Adelaide come home hard to beat Glenelg by 16. Let's take a look at the final round.
Round 23. Port finished its season on a high with a come-from-behind win against Glenelg at the Bay. Zane Kirkwood, the star for the Magpies, with 35 disposals. Norwood handed North its fifth loss in succession at Cooper Stadium. Red leg Darren Pfeiffer winding back the clock with this torpedo from 55 metres. A 10-goal final term allowed Central to steamroll Sturt at Unley. Bulldog Braden O'Hara amassing 41 disposals and 12 marks.
He's kicked it towards the goals and he's kicked it!
And the Eagles claimed the double chance with a 71-point win at Richmond. Andrew Anger starring with 7 goals and this contender for Mark of the Year. Round 23. Sturt versus Central District. Central District, Jay Glenn, one vote. Sturt, M. Yench, two votes. Central District, B. O'Hara, three votes. West Adelaide versus Eagles. Eagles, S. Lewis, one vote. Eagles, A. Anger, two votes. Eagles, P. Stewart, three votes. Norwood versus North Adelaide. Norwood, T. Weber, one vote. Norwood, M. Fuller, two votes. Norwood, M. Thomas, three votes. Glenelg versus Port Adelaide. Glenelg, J. Davenport, one vote. Port Adelaide, S. Summerton, two votes. Port Adelaide, Z. Kirkwood, three votes. And that completes the voting for round 23.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have much pleasure in declaring the winner of the 2013 McGarry Medal from the Norwood Football Club, Matthew Thomas.
We're going to get you a check too, Matty. Steve, if you'd like to do the honours. Steve, present Matty with the check. You need a shot for the camera. There you go. Matty, I'm going to hand the podium over to you to make some speeches.
Well, I'm not often speechless, so I'd really like to thank the SANFL, obviously. It's a great competition with so many fantastic players in it, and it's a real privilege to be able to come back and play in such a great league. Firstly, to Nathan Bassett, he's been fantastic this year for me, coming back and, you know, obviously every now and then pretty disappointed. I would like to have been playing for the Power, but found myself at home with the boys. And Bass and Rossi have just been terrific, helping me to settle in and fit in and play in different roles. Bass got me playing up forward a little bit as well, which is trying to develop my game. And at 26, it's great to be able to still try and develop your game, so I thank Bass for that. My teammates all here tonight have been fantastic, absolutely awesome. You know, there's some big things to happen for us in the next month, so it's going to be pretty exciting. And I haven't played finals for 8 years, so and I don't think I've played in final or in a grand final since I was 16, so it'd be pretty nice to get somewhere along those lines and see if we can get a back-to-back or something like that would be great. To my family and friends, have been terrific support. Mum and Dad, obviously, in Melbourne, so they've been fantastic for me and my career. And Stacey, my girlfriend, moved over this year from Brisbane. Couldn't have done it without her. She's been awesome. And to all the other boys that have got votes tonight, great work. And, yeah, good luck in the finals. Thanks.
Matty Thomas, well done. Matty, it's been a fair rollercoaster for you the last 30 hours or so, hasn't it? Have you dealt with that?
Oh, I'm still dealing with it, to be honest. Yeah, look, you know, everyone, guys in the room, you know, Jimmy Ezar, Brad Symes, and boys like that have been through this before and come out the other side. And for me, it's been a pretty hard sort of 24 hours. I didn't sleep much last night. And looking forward to just getting out on the weekend and playing some good footy and just enjoying it. I haven't enjoyed my footy as much as I have this year, which is a bit of a conundrum, really. I don't know how many people can enjoy their footy with so much pressure, but it's been great to just come out and play for such a great club. And, you know, yeah, I'm speechless, to be honest.
Matty, you mentioned you pay tribute to Nathan, to Mark Ross as well. But just personally for yourself, to have the disappointment of missing out on playing footy for the Power, but coming back playing such wonderful footy for Norwood, how did you keep yourself up?
Coming back, you know, the smiles that walk through the door, you know, they're happy to see you, they can't wait to play with you, and get around each other, and just that keeps you upbeat and playing exciting footy that Norwood do. You know, winning games always helps. I know when you win games, it's a lot easier to get up the next week, and just trying to each week just trying to improve and trying to prove people wrong as well, which is a bit of a motivation.
Matty, of course, the AFL dream, as we said a bit earlier, still alive in your mind.
Yeah, absolutely. I hope to get back in there if I can, and if I can't, I'm at home at Norwood. So, you know, I'm pretty happy with where I'm at the moment. So.
Big month coming up for your footy club.
Massive. Yeah, I'm still shaking. I've got to apologise.
You're the McGarry medalist.
Yeah. Wow.
Good on you, mate. You get a big month. Congratulations, mate. I think to see your performance, and we saw it with Brad Symes last year as well, to come back into the competition. When things aren't going well, to play so well, I think is fantastic. We love seeing that, mate. Congratulations. We wish you all the best for the coming month and also for next year. Our McGarry medalist, Matt Thomas, I'd now like to ask John Olsen, the chairman of the SA Football Commission, to propose a toast to our 2013 McGarry medalist.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please join me and be upstanding to toast the 2013 McGarry medalist, Matthew Thomas, Norwood Football Club. Matthew, congratulations.
Well done. Well done, guys. Don't drink too much of that. Thank you very much, Matty. You can relax now. You've got some official duties that you need to do. So, media, we're going to go and do a press conference with Matty so that we can get all that tidied. John, thank you very much. Congratulations to everyone. Matty, go and relax. Take your check down there. We'll just have a look at the final leaderboard at the completion of round 23. So Matty Thomas, 26 votes, powered home with voting in seven of his last eight games. 18 votes in those eight games, which is quite amazing. So a wonderful effort there. Sammy Gray, the 21-year-old, well done, Sam. Some great work by you as well. And Mitch Grigg, what a year he had. Plenty of votes early on before he went in to play some terrific AFL football. James Boyd again. Always amongst the votes. Zane Kirkwood had a terrific year with the most possessions in the comp. Maxi Thring doing very well there for North Adelaide on 14. Braden O'Hara, a terrific year. Joel Cross, last year's winner. And also Matty Goldsworthy on 12. That wraps up the formal proceedings. Thank you very much. Thank you to all of our sponsors and supporters. Stick around, enjoy the hospitality of the SANFL. We'll see you again soon. Thanks for coming.